Recently, we made a video on 50 awesome YouTube tools to help you get more views in less time. If you haven't watched it already, click here right now. If you have already watched it, well done. You're halfway there. Here's another 50. Once you have the vidIQ Chrome extension installed, you will see a button in your browser. Click it and you will find two sets of shortcuts. The first provides links to all the major YouTube pages, so wherever you are on the internet, you can always jump straight to where you want to be on YouTube with these links. The second set of shortcuts link to vidIQ's own web applications, full of fantastic YouTube tools, so let's delve right in. Analytics is our first destination with a wide range of enhanced YouTube analytics. You can minimize many of the panels or move them about to bring the ones that interest you the most to the top of the page. As well as minimizing panels, some of them can be expanded to reveal more information, such as the playlist panel. Now let's take a look at some of the analytics in more detail. The best time to post panel tracks when your subscribers are most active on YouTube to calculate when the best time is to publish your videos. In this example, prime hotspots are weekends and the afternoons. The trend analytics is good for taking a snapshot of your channel's general health, tracking growth over 7 and 30 day periods. You'll also find these three top panels that you can customize between top YouTube searches for your videos, most views from which country, most embedded views, and most video views over a 30-day period. And if you've ever wanted a graph that collates YouTube views, minutes watched, likes, dislikes, subscribers gained, subscribers lost, and comments for each and every single day all into one, well, you'll find it right here. At the top of the vidIQ web apps page, you'll find links to other tools, so let's take a look at the video page next. Just like the native YouTube Video Manager page, this does list important analytics for your videos, but the settings button in the top left hand corner allows you to add and remove statistics to match your preferences. Some of the columns will either offer suggestions, such as adding tags for videos, where none exist. If you click on a video, a panel to the right hand side will sweep in to give you even more analytics, as well as tools to edit the video title and description, schedule a video to be published, delete the video, and so on. Now, if you've connected your Facebook Pages account to vidIQ, you can look at the performance of your Facebook videos too, which will be quite useful if you're sending your content from YouTube to Facebook through vidIQ's syndication tool. The tools just keep on coming with subscriber analysis. This takes a sample of your current subscribers and tracks what videos they are liking from other video makers as well as other YouTubers they are subscribing to. It stands to reason that some of this content will be similar to yours, so you might want to go check these videos and channels out for yourself. See if there are any techniques you could adopt or similar channels you can collaborate with. And as you might expect, each of these videos and channels include direct links back to YouTube. Let's return now to the topic of search engine optimization, because the next vidIQ web app tab is full of useful tools. Bulk SEO is the first on the list. This shows you how well your tags are performing for a video by counting how many times a search term has brought a viewer to that video. Sometimes viewers may even be finding your video through a search term you've not even added to your video tags, so this is the perfect opportunity to add that tag to your video to help improve its discoverability. You can also quickly edit your video title and description here to include words and phrases from the most popular search tags, and you can sort the video list either by best opportunities to optimize or most recently analyzed, which is done on a daily basis. Channel-wide tags harvest all of the tags from all of your videos to see how well they perform. You can sort by any of the columns, so it's interesting to see if a tag you use ranks on the first page of a YouTube search for that tag and how many times your videos rank for the search term. If you do rank highly and frequently, that means you're doing a good job within a particular search term. The last three columns calculate the score of a search term to help you decide whether it's a term that's high in demand and if you can realistically compete with other channels for that search term. If any of the tags you see on this page are of particular interest, you can highlight them in order to copy them, and if you want to see how tags you use are shifting over time, you can set a period of time. So you might see best ranked tags go up, search volumes go down, and how overall tag scores fluctuate over time. If the channel-wide tags page focuses on your own tags, the keyword research tool gives you the power to search for any keyword and see how well it performs on YouTube. You can use this tool to research, compare and sort related keywords, search volume, competition score and number of words, which is really useful for discovering long-tail keywords. This is the sort of tool that can help you build an entire channel, and of course a copy tags feature is included. For an overview of what content is popular right now, the trending keywords tab is the place to be. These keywords and videos will change frequently, which is why you have options to choose keywords over the last day or week, and which YouTube category to look at. Alright, this next one is an absolute monster, so strap yourselves in. Simply take any username from a YouTube channel and add it via the Compare Channels box, and this will give you an instant comparison for all sorts of datasets, such as views, subscribers, average daily views, average daily subscribers, and so on. You can choose to look at this data as totals, cumulative, or daily over 30 days, 60 days, or all time. And things start to get really interesting when you add several channels into the mix. We call this the Competitors tool, and it will give you an insight into how channels like yours are performing. So, if a competitor enjoys a sudden spike in viewership, you might want to look at their channel and see what content you might have missed. We're not finished yet, however, because underneath the graph, channel snapshots will display which way the channel is trending over the last month, and below that, you can see which videos are trending for the selected channels as they are sorted by views per hour. Let's return to YouTube itself now for a few more handy tools. The comment filter tool helps you pick out such things as questions, comments with positive or negative words, as well as comments from specific users. You can even bundle different criteria together if you want to search for comments that contain questions that you haven't responded to yet that include positive words. And if that's not enough, if you want to search for influential YouTubers, you can search by minimum number of subscribers. At the same time as filtering those commenters, it will also show you exactly how many subscribers the commenter has. These comment filter tools are available from both the YouTube Comment Manager page and from your individual video pages. On the same subjects as your own videos, you can click the vidIQ tool button to copy video cards, send a video to Facebook, create thumbnails and more. That same button on other YouTubers' videos only allows you to embed the video. At the bottom of video thumbnails on YouTube, you will see this blue red bar. This shows you the likes to dislikes ratio, very good for sniffing out clickbaity videos. Below that is an engagement snapshot of a video, and you can mouse over it for even more information. On the video card creation screen, once you've finished making your cards, you can save them as a template and then load them into other videos, saving you the hassle of manually creating the cards all over again. Now, if by chance you don't like the real-time stats bar or the thumbnail likes dislikes bar, you can turn them off by clicking on the vidIQ button and choosing settings at the very bottom. Two simple checkboxes here allow you to turn both features off if you want to, so that your YouTube pages will change from looking like this to looking like this. And finally, if you want more information on any of the tools featured in this video and a whole lot more tips, tricks and guides for getting more YouTube views in less time, then subscribe to vidIQ. And all of that leaves us with just one question. Where do I get all of these amazing tools? Simple answer. It's all part of the vidIQ Chrome extension, so download it today and start enjoying most of these tools for absolutely free. And that is literally it. I have run out of stuff to show you for the time being. We'll have to conjure up some new toys to impress you. In the meantime, do let us know what your favourite tool is from this batch and what you would like to see in the future. Thank you very much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your video making day. Bye for now. If I've got 50 tools here and another 50 here, what happens if I put them together? Stay tuned for that.